folks, and welcome back to another lesson. Now, this one is going out to my buddy, Dan Cleary. Mr. Dan Cleary, everyone. Now, if you know what Rareform Radio is, which is what this t-shirt is, then you will have heard of him already. It's a really funny podcast. You can see it on YouTube and lots of other places, so go check that out. Now, Dan is also a very well-respected guitar tech. He's worked with Dave Navarro, Peter DiStefano from Porno for Pyros, and loads of others. He's also played in some pretty cool bands as well. So this one's going out for you, Dan. Hope you enjoy it, buddy. So first off, let's check out some tones. So I'm using my Tokai with the bare knuckle pickup Holy Divers, like an 80s voiced set of humbuckers. And I'm only using one pedal, this bad boy, the Thorpe FX Gunshot, which is a really cool distortion pedal. Now the original is tuned down half a step. I'm not doing that today. I'm going to teach you this in standard tuning, but if you want to play along with the original, just bear that in mind. So intro riff goes like this. So you start off with an A power chord. That rings out for seven beats. Then you play this. So you've got 7, 9, 8, okay? And then you're playing flat fingered stuff, right? So you've got the 7th fret and the 5th fret. Now, if you want to simplify it, you don't really need to be playing anything on the D string. You can just play. You can just focus on the G and the B string, okay? But I'm going to give you the full chord, so, you know, you've got the option. So, this rhythm. And the same rhythm, but then you're going to play a C shape to a G shape, okay? And here you switch to a power chord, but with the root on the D, okay? So a little palm mute on that, on the root first, okay? So again. That comes up 2 frets, same shape. A little whack just before it. And here we're into just double stops, okay? So 5th fret, and I would use my 2nd and 3rd finger there because you're going to need to have your 1st finger tucked in behind on the 4th fret for the next bit. So again. And again, it's easier to do the vibrato as well there because slash does quite a bit of vibrato in this. Then you go around again, but a slight variation towards the end. So you're going to play. So you've got that. Before we go into the verse riff, okay? So that is just a pull off from the 2nd fret double stop. Okay, so that little phrase. Now, this phrase comes in. In fact, that's one times round of the verse riff. But the riff actually starts on the 4 and, okay? So the A you go to, it's 1, 2, 3. So that A was played on the 4 and, okay? So that goes right the way through the whole pattern. But you start off with 0, 3, palm muted. So the 1st and the 4th measure are the same. It's this. Okay, that's the 1st and the 4th. And then in between we have this. Okay, so that's bars 2 and 3. So let's spend a little bit of time on bars 2 and 3. We've got. Now there, I'm using my 3rd finger to get that bend on the 3rd fret, okay? And it's a slight bend. I don't even think it's half a step even. And then you've got an extra little bit. Okay. And then into the fourth bar. So the whole thing through slowly. One, two, three. Okay, that's the whole thing. Couple of fills. The second time you're going to play this. You do a little artificial harmonic bend and release on the 7th fret, the 5th. Just in the 4th bar. Next time round, another variation is you do the artificial harmonic on the bend. And then the 4th time round, we have this. So slowly that is. Okay, so then you go to a D5. You could play the full D if you can get it in. I just go for a D5 there. But there's also some 8th notes. Just like that. Then you got this little rundown. And then back in. The way I play this is I do a little slide from 7 to 5. And then a pull off. And then I change here. I've got my first and second finger right on the 5th fret, right? So I've changed it from flat to 2 fingers. And then that allows me to slide down, right? Because I find doing a pull off there, just my fingers just don't like that. So if you could do a pull off there, then go for that. But I'm going to do it this way. Okay, so I slide first finger down 2 frets. And my second finger down 1 fret. And then you just do a series of harmonics, just moving towards the nut. Okay, then another verse, there's no extra fills. And then coming out of it, it's. Then you go into the intro again. And then you're into the chorus part, right? The only difference there is run down, but then you go to the G5, okay? And then you do a few palm mutes, so it's all 8th notes. So the dynamics come up there. And then you're back into that little fill. And then the chorus is this. Pretty straightforward. Again, very bluesy. So it's just. Just play that over and over again, right? After the 5th time, you then play. So essentially, it's A to F to G. So those are the chords underneath that, right? So, again. Okay, and then you're in a sort of F5 position. Then I go to the 3rd fret with my 2nd finger. Because then I use my 3rd and 1st to do that little run underneath. Okay, and then you're back around. Again, round five times, and then after that you play. And for the pick slide, make sure you're hitting at least the A and the D, right? You don't need to press too hard. Just, I mean, I've got quite a large pick here, but, you know, that's the way to do that. And then we're into Izzy solo. Let me play that through for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And then into Slash's part, okay? So the solo comes in on the one and, so there is an eighth note rest at the beginning, and you're starting with an upstroke on the seventh fret, and then the bend on the ninth fret that follows it is a full step bend, okay? So you're gonna do a couple of those. Flatten your first finger on the seventh fret on the to cover the E and the B, and play two there. Okay, then you go back to some more bends. You do another three. Then, double stop bend, ninth fret. Okay, you can either play it with your third finger and push both, or use your third and fourth finger, right? Little rundown. Pretty straightforward, that is. You've just got 10, 9, 7, 10, 9, 7. And then you've got a bend and release. And then this. And then a series of slides. And the slides go 9, 7, 7, 6, 6, 4, 4, 2. Like that, okay? So that part again slowly. And you've got those five chords, right? So it's 2, 3, 4, 5. Awesome. And then we've got Slash's solo, which is cool. It's like this. Right, let's stop there. We've got... series of cool country rock style bends. So you want 9th and 10th fret minimum. If you can get in the 10th fret on the E every now and again, that's cool too. So there you're bending up, releasing, while the 10th fret is still held. And then you go down to the 7th fret. Same thing twice, right? Then... slide from the 9th to the 11th, and then you play. Okay, so again. And if you can catch the B string when you get to the top of that bend, and then return it, then, you know, you'll get a bit closer to what he plays. I mean, I forget, I'm just playing. I tend to play that just from memory, but you know, you've got two options there, and then you go into this part. Okay, so that part is just... very Slash, very bluesy. Then you go 12, 13. Slight bend, and then this little run, lovely little lick, and you can play an open, you know, note there if you're still playing, because you want to get up to the 17th fret for the next bit. Next bit's tricky, so it's quite quick. So that's going to take some practice. So you're starting on the 17th fret. Bend that up a full step, and then you're going to do this rundown. such a cool film. And that little bit at the end. So there's a couple of tricky bits to this. One, it's fast. Two, you're going to be playing across different strings with the same finger. Or you could tuck, you know, one behind. If you play with your third finger a lot rather than your little finger, you might find it easier. You know, to use your second finger when you get there. You know, you could do it there as well. Or just use one finger like I'm doing, right? So that one, you're just going to have to play it slowly and build it up. Get that bit first. Next part is... Get that bit, then you tag on this bit. That's the bit that's going to take the time. Or... I find it easier to just do it that way. And then again, that's the last part. So again, one more time. Then we got some cool bluesy stuff. Bend, etc. So this is brilliant. This is one of my favorite bits of the solo. We've got so 7 7 7 6 7, and here I'm muting the G string with my second finger. So you're not hearing it ring out, okay? There we've got little palm mute on the 7th fret there. Another one on the 9th fret when you get there. Then you go 10, 11, okay? Little rundown there, okay? So we've got... So for these ones, 5, 6 and 10, 11, I'm using my first and my second finger in that order there. And then for the other ones, I'm using my second and third, okay? So I'm alternating between those. Then we've got a bend on the 4th fret. That's a little tricky too, because you've got... flatten, or you can use your little finger and move from 4 to 5. Probably easiest. But then again, you've got to use the little finger to get the 5th fret on the next string down to do that little rundown, right? You got a little bend at the end there, okay? So, one more time. Now, if you can't nail the bend, which I really can, then you can always slide up right to the 4th fret. You know, you can do that if you wish. Don't worry too much about it. It should be fun. Next up, we got this. So all that is 0, 1, 2. And a double stop on the B and E. And then back down. Play that round twice. Then we got this build-up part that goes straight into like a variation of the intro. And then you play this. Now here, you're going to do a 1.5 step bend, which is really tricky down here, right? Now you get that going on, right? It's super hard to do. That is just a little bit more, you know, kind of rockiness, isn't there, to it? I'm playing and a slide and some, you know, some vibrato. Here, I think he's playing. If not, you could just play it as you did before. Then you're into the outro part, I think. I don't think it goes back into another verse there. And that would be... got into that sort of stuff, and then there's an outro solo which goes on for a while. So that little bit again, so you're just staying on the F twice there. Now here, Slash branches off into an outro solo. I have tabbed it, patrons, so check that out over there, but I haven't had a chance to learn it properly. But essentially, it's just... got a load of... So loads of stuff. It's a big old solo at the end. So if you do want that, comment below and I'll do a little addendum lesson on that. But for now, people, hopefully that is enough for you. Enjoy, and thanks so much, Dan. Take it easy, mate. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye.